Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the another video on Jetpack Compose, and we will continue to explore Jetpack navigation. While ending the previous video, I had said that if you knew the view model concepts, then you can pretty much achieve the same thing in a much more refined manner. And in this video, I just want to showcase that in a very crisp manner. And the concept behind this is pretty old one. You might have already seen it. You typically have this bulletin board. Management usually writes messages that it wants to communicate to the whole university or the student community. It puts the message on the bulletin board, and whoever is passing by the bulletin board can read it and get the message. This is the whole idea behind this. In our case, it is not management and the student. It is screen 1 and screen 2 who will be writing to this bulletin board. The bulletin board is not really a bulletin board. It is actually a view model. And because this view model is shared between screen 1 and screen 2, the approach is basically called shared view model approach to pass the data between two screens when the navigation happens. Enough of theory, let's try to understand how this is actually implemented. So this is the same old codebase that you saw in the previous video. Now we will have to update this particular code to work with view model. Before we start writing our view models, we will have to add the appropriate dependencies to the Gradle build file. So let me open the build.gradle file, and here I think we need a bit more. Let me add the lab cycle version, and then let me add couple of other dependencies that are needed for this thing to work. You can just do a quick search on why I am adding these dependencies. Basically, with Kotlin, if you want to work with view model and live data and save the state, then you need these things. So that's the whole reason behind why I am adding these dependencies to the project. So we are good with this. The first thing that we will do is we will create a view model. So let me close all of this. Let me create a new package. Let me call it as view model. And here, let me create a Kotlin class, and let me keep it simple, shared view model. And this extends view model. And then val student is equal to mutable live data, and which is of student type. And now we basically have our shared view model. People who have been following CodeTutor, the concept of view model and live data is not completely new. We have covered this in the 10th video of the Jetpack Compose series itself, or there is an Android architecture series where we have done a very detailed explanation of what is view model and what is live data. So I assume that you know how to work with live data and view model. If not, just go back, understand those concepts, and then come back here. So now we have this shared view model. What we will have to do is we will have to now initialize it. Now the thing is, which is the best place to initialize it? Let me just open app.kt. I have initialized the nav controller. So let me also initialize the view model. So shared view model is equal to remember shared view model. And now what we will have to do is we will have to pass this particular shared view model to the app scaffold. So let me open the app scaffold in the split screen. Let me go back to the definition here. And here what I will do is I will add shared view model as well, and then pass the shared view model. I now want to basically pass this particular shared view model to the get my nav graph so that in there I can pass this view model. So shared view model is there. Now let me open common UI utils, and here let me just prettify this, that is option command L, and then add shared view model, as the another parameter so that I can pass the shared view model. And now here in screen 1, I should be able to pass the shared view models. So let me just open screen 1, shared view model, and screen 2, once again pass shared view model. And now if I go back here, I should pass the shared view model to basically take care of this compilation errors. And now in screen 1, what I can do is, just before I navigate, I will write shared view model dot student dot value is equal to sample student. So I just initialized this with sample student, and after initializing it here in the shared view model, I actually don't need this. So I can get rid of this and also go to the common utilities here, and here also I can completely get rid of this. Now it is all being managed through shared view model. So one part is done, and now let me open the screen 2, and here I don't need all of this complicated code. What I will do is shared view model dot student dot value, and that's it. And if I run this, it should work. So let me run this. So this is screen 1, and when I click on screen 2, I got the data. So let me just go back here and let me update it to say John Doe. Instead of writing it John Doe, let me write it Ankit Nahar. Let me restart this again, and if I just go there, that's the value that I got. So this is a very simple mechanism, and you can actually build on top of this, where you combine your view model with the repository. That would also be very simple. Probably I will show you that very quickly in the next video. So as of now, this is good enough. So stay tuned for the next video.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.